I'd love to do a musical.
I'd like to do a musical too.
Yes, Elton songs, amazing. I think I'm about to do a whole lot more of them, actually. But
are you now?
Yeah, I think so. That's my next thing. But yeah, oh, thank wow. you. I'm so proud.
Seeing
of
Elton John.
I think so. Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
My God.
Yeah,
Taron.
Yeah.
They're planning a biographical film on a certain part of Elton John's life, and I believe that that part is going to be played by someone who's on the couch right now. Can we talk about this? The fact that you're...
Let's talk about it. Yeah.
You're going to be playing Elton John.
I am indeed. I'm going to be playing Elton John in the musical.
Instantly, the minute he sat at the piano, there was a sense about him that he knew exactly what kind of approach he was going to take to this. So upon seeing his posture, working with him a little bit, and then getting him to improvise with two hands, I quickly knew within 1 hour that this was going to work out very nicely indeed.
It has been the most daunting thing I've ever done. The first day of filming, we were filming a relatively innocuous kind of connective bit, and all I really had to do was walk across the space and say, 3 or 4 syllables. I thought, oh my word, this is going to be, this is just not, what am I doing? You can't play Elton John. Why on earth did you do this?
Taron has this very innate, likable, vulnerable quality. When you've got an actor like Taron who's so engaged and given an opportunity to do something where he's allowed to snot and dribble and sweat and scream and shout and then sing a song and, you know, it's like... Having that kind of energy and force on the set as well was an incredible gift. He was just the right man for the job. I can't imagine anybody else who would have just. And it's not just about a physical transformation. Sure, he shaved his hairline and he puffed up his eyebrows, but there's nothing else that's done. It's really about how he inhabits, you know, that character that we imagine.
I can sing Matthew. I'm on it.
Hide behind that mask you use.
He can sing like an angel as well.
Trying to look like I know what I'm doing.
I can't lie. No more of your darkness.
Taron made it sound like it was kind of really lovely and easy. He worked so hard. I can't tell you how much effort and time, energy, and what he went through to deliver this performance. Genuinely, it's incredible.
The first time I got in today, I felt a little bit, I got quite nervous. I called for air, because I'm kind of quite deep. It's at least, I don't know, I'm at least sort of 10 metres down, I think. The diver who's helping Pete was great, but I just was expecting it a bit quicker, and it kind of frightened me, and then it took a little while for me to sort of get myself back into the game, really.
My excitement has just grown and grown and grown throughout the process. It's just been the greatest joy of my professional life making this film. Now that it's done.
It's really strange.
Shit. Rocket Man, Taron Egerton.
And a Golden Globe goes to Taron Egerton, Rocket Man.
This is Taron Egerton's first nomination and first win.
This role has changed my life. It's been the best experience of my life. I am so proud of the film. We've poured our heart and soul into it. And of course, what matters is the work, and we're very, very proud of it. But it's really nice to have a Golden Globe as well.
My mother is in here somewhere. This one's for you, ma'am.
How's that?